Welcome to today's GEMU keynote presentation. My name is Marco Becker and I will be guiding you through the webinar. To help you with any scheduling, I can tell you right away that this presentation will last approximately 20 to 25 minutes. You can use the chat function to ask your questions either directly during the presentation or afterwards. But now I'd like to present you the title of today's series. We would like to show you how to make your filling process even faster and even more flexible. Here on my side, our today's speaker, Christoph Winter. He will also be available in the chat afterwards. Christoph, I would like to hand over to you now and I would ask you for a brief introduction of yourself.
Thank you, Marco, for your introduction. My name is Christoph Winter. I'm strategic product manager for globe valves, control valves, and filling valves. I am responsible for the portfolio development of these valve types and assist our sales team in advising our customers. This also regarding the growing demands on electrical actuators. In recent years, GEMU has developed a new valve technology for filling applications to make filling processes faster, more precise, and more hygienic. This makes the plants more efficient, increases service periods, and reduces maintenance effort.
Christoph, you have mentioned the increasing demand of electrically actuators. So before we go into the details of filling, I would like to broaden this term of electrification. Electrification has been on everyone's lips since the past few years. Generally speaking, this refers to plant components that are being actuated with electrical current rather than by compressed air. Christoph, what is the reason for that?
For example, electrical valves are more efficient because no compressed air is needed to be retained and energy is only consumed when the valve is actuated. Compressed air can also contain particles and there are some areas such as insulators where such unclean compressed air should be avoided. Another advantage is that electrically operated components can be actuated and controlled with greater precision.
GEMU recognized the strength of electrification a long time ago. We have been one of the first manufacturers that have experimented with motorized actuators and brought them to market about the early 80s. We therefore have a great deal of long-standing experience and also in-house expertise to define these specific solutions. Thanks, Christoph, for this brief digression into electrification. Now let's get back to the main topic of today, the filling. Can you outline which solutions for filling processes have been used until now?
Now we want to focus mainly on the filling of foodstuffs and beverages. Today they are mostly used pneumatic valves. The medium is located directly on the moving parts of the actuators, separated only by sliding seals. You can imagine how fast you can get a contamination if the sealing is not longer 100% effective. Furthermore, pneumatic valves must first be controlled via pilot valves, which considerably delays the reaction time. These filling principles has clearly been established in the last decades, and most users manage this electropneumatic control system very well and achieve the desired output quantities. But GEMU would not be GEMU if we did not have the ambition to constantly optimize our products for our customers. So in addition to the F40 pneumatic filling valve, a completely electric version was developed, which is so far unique in the market.
Mm-hmm. Christoph, which technologies has GEMU used for its new developments?
Together with a well-known development partner of servo motors, GEMU has developed high-performance servo motors with linear actuators for valve applications. These low-loss and brushless servo motors are characterized by their high driving speed, precise positioning accuracy, and fast controllability. They are robust and durable with the stainless steel design of protection glass IP69K. Depending on the application, between 50 and 100 million cycle duties can be achieved. We have combined the GEMU servo drive technology with the innovative PD sealing concept, which was specially developed for the requirements of filling and control processes.
Christoph, you have mentioned the PD sealing concept. What means this? What is PD standing for?
PD stands for plug diaphragm. The PDFE TFM ensures a hermetic sealing between actuator and medium. The PD sealing technology impresses with its high resistance to nearly all media, its long service life, and its compliant with FDA and EG Directive 1935. Therefore, this technology is ideal for use in the pharmaceutical and foodstuffs industry.
You have mentioned now a lot of technical advantages of this valve. What is the particular customer benefit of these technical advantages?
The F60 is controlled completely electrical, so it can be directly connected to the machine control system. The filling processes can be digitally programmed directly via the control unit and performed in a reliable manner. The near real-time actuation and fast driving speed of F60 ensures that response and filling times can be reduced in comparison to designs currently in use. Different filling volumes, changes to the containers, or different fill fluids can be handled reproducible by using a pre-programmed and validated filling program. The servo drive motor is freely positionable, allowing special filling curves to be programmed for an optimal filling. A slow filling at the beginning, a fast filling by filling the main quantity, and a slow complete filling in the end. Depending on the media and process, other filling curves can be programmed individually.
So in a sense, filling is a matter of hygiene, speed, accuracy, and long service lives. How is this implemented by the F60?
You're right, these are the key criteria. On this slide, you can see a filling process of milk in multi-layer beverage cartons, as it often carried out with pneumatic valves today. With the F60, this process can be enacted more hygienic, faster, and more accurate. So, this linear filling process can be optimized and the output quantity increased. A switch to other media, such as fruit juice or other dairy products, is possible very easy. Ladies and gentlemen, on the next slide, you can see a continuous filling of milk. Here the F60 can display its full potential. The multi-layer stripes are welded lengthwise and directly fill, so only a short moment is available in which the filling must be completed. An extremely fast and precisely controllable valve is required to fill the containers with the correct quantity in the short period of time. The F60 is very well suited for such an application due to its fast response performance and high flow rates. On this slide, you can see a quite specific application. A nitrogen supposition can be integrated into the filling process with a second filling valve for oxygen-sensitive products. The sense and purpose of those supposition is to avoid oxygen in the filled containers. For this application, a second F60 is used to blow the nitrogen into the continuous layer tubes after every filling cycle, before sealing the containers to push the oxygen away.
Christoph, we have right now received a question from chat regarding regulations. You have already mentioned that they comply with FDA and 1935. And now is the question whether these valves have also the 3A conformity.
Okay, very important, 3A conformity. We have the 3A conformity for the F60. There is a special version available with leak detection round about the actuator and the 3A certification onto the valve.
Well, thank you very much. Christoph, coming back to the filling process, what you have described now was the filling of non-carbonated foodstuff. From experience, carbonated beverages behave a little bit different. And now the question, is it also possible for the F60 to fill carbonated beverages like mineral water or beer?
In principle, you can fill every viscous or liquid media with the F60 filling valve. As mentioned, for a filling of carbonized liquids, you must use a complete filling system with the media valve and the auxiliary valves for the CO2 management. On the slide, you can see a filling block with the F60 and three auxiliary valves. When filling carbonated beverages, the bottle is firmly pressed onto the ceiling of the block. With the first auxiliary valve, a vacuum is created in the bottle to remove the contained atmospheric oxygen. In the next step, CO2 is introduced into the bottle using the second auxiliary valve. This so-called CO2 flushing is generally repeated once or twice. Now the actual filling process is done via the media valve. During the media filling, the CO2 is discharged via the third auxiliary valve out of the bottle. It is important that there is still a low overpressure after the media filling is completed in the bottle to prevent a penetration of oxygen. The bottle is now released from the ceiling of the block and sealed with a screw cap or ground cap according to the medium.
What you have mentioned now is still the filling principle as it is used by pneumatic valves, isn't it?
Yes, that's right. But now imagine that you would have no compressed air in the entire filling machine and make your filling process more hygienic, faster and more accurate. So F60 is usable if it depends on the flexibility of the filling machine.
Mm-hmm. Christoph, let's talk about costs. When I could imagine that in terms of procurement costs, the electrical valves are even higher than the pneumatic versions. But assuming that you are saving compressed air, I could imagine that with terms of operating costs, the picture differs a little bit between electric and pneumatic valves. What could you tell us about that?
Yes, that's right. The decision for a technology should not only be based on the procurement costs of a system. You must note all costs over the entire operating time of a filling machine. On the next slide, we want to show you a total cost of ownership comparison between pneumatic and electric filling machines. As you can see in the graphic, the total costs of pneumatic system after approximately 25 million filling cycles per filling point exceed the total costs of an electrical system. the advantages in terms of longer maintenance periods, faster filling cycles, and a higher output are still not considered in this TCO.
Christoph, you have just mentioned the maintenance. Could you briefly illustrate how these valves are maintained?
Yes, that's no problem. The service of the F60 can be done very easily. Over the thread, you can remove the actuator from the body. Then you can remove the PD. Change it into a new one, which can be screwed very easily. And then bring the actuator back to the body. You have to fasten the actuator, and then you can go on with your filling process.
Okay, thank you very much, Christoph. Another product you've brought along today is the 567 servo drive. Also, this is an electrically operated valve. It looks quite similar to the F60. Could you tell us what are the differences of these products?
You are right. The two valves look very similar. They're based on the same technology, the GEMU servo drive actuator and the PD sealing system. While F60 is mainly developed for filling applications, the GEMU 567 regulating valve is designed for applications with the highest control requirements. The wide range of regulating cones can be used to determine different flow rates with very high precision. GEMU 567 can also be used as pressure control valve to maintain an absolute constant pressure during a process. Because of its real-time actuation, the blend control system can immediately respond to very small pressure fluctuations during the process.
The main features of the 567 are its fast actuation and its precise controllability of processes. How is it practically implemented within an application?
On the slide, you can see a mixing application. Imagine that two media are to be mixed in a precise mixing relation. Each medium flow is measured by a flow meter, reported to the machine control system. Depending on the mixing relation required, the two 567 valves can be moved to precisely the correct position. If, for example, something changes in the upstream process of the two supply lines, the valve will respond immediately and the mixing relation is kept constant.
Mm-hmm. Are there applications in which two of these valves have to be used? So both of them?
For example, a plant which combines mixing with filling applications. In the movie, you can see a mixture of fruit juice concentrate with water in a previously defined mixing relation by 567 valve. At the filling point, the fruit juice is now precisely filled into a can with the F60. At the same time, a sample of fruit juice mixture is filled for tasting. As you can see, with the growing requirements, common technologies reach their limits. The first who will switch to new and innovative technologies will have the best chances in the competition of the future.
Christoph, thank you very much for your presentation. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope we could make you curious with our GEMU keynote webinar. The material covered by Christoph today was only a small range of our comprehensive product portfolio. We are also able to integrate these electrical actuators on our multi-port valve blocks and therefore can create even more specific solutions. Ask us about what we can offer, either directly in the live chat or afterwards by getting in touch with our GEMU sales team. Thank you very much for your attention and we wish you a nice day. Further information on our electrical valves you can also find on the internet. Thank you.